Okay, well, hello everyone. My name is Lisa Lee. I'm here with Mike Johnson from Easy Ride, and we are the bike and pedestrian safety team. And we're gonna talk to you all today about safety tips for pedestrians and drivers. Let's see if I can. So walking, we're gonna start by talking about walking first, and then we'll move on to the driver safety tips. So walking is great exercise, it's healthy. Can any of you tell me if you know how many minutes a day of exercise adults need to stay healthy? And Mike, I'm gonna need your help here because like I said, I can't see anyone. You can either put your answer in the chat or you can unmute yourself and just answer.
I'd say an hour.
That's a great guess, Tom. But it's actually, adults only really need to have 30 minutes of vigorous heart pumping exercise to stay at your current rate of health. So if you're trying to become healthier, then an hour is good. But the experts recommend 30 minutes a day for adults. You can either group that, you know, into a couple of sessions of an hour, or you can do 30 minutes every day. So some of the benefits of walking are emotional, social, and mental health. You know, getting enough exercise helps to reduce stress. It puts us in a happier mood. You know, we get those endorphins from working out and getting, you know, moving our bodies. It also helps us to get a better night's sleep. And, you know, as we get older, it's definitely more important to try and get in, you know, our 6 to 8 hours, because that is when our body renews itself. So even though as we age, our bodies kind of start wanting us to sleep less, try not to give into that. Try and get, you know, as much sleep as you can, because it's better for your body, better for your mental health. Some of the other physical benefits, obviously, you know, walking helps to strengthen our bones, our joints, our muscles, and it helps with our heart. And it gives us that more energy and our daily exercise. It also is a great way to help reduce climate change, right? So if we can walk and move around not using our vehicles, you know, for short trips, we can help to reduce auto emissions. And you can see in this cute little chart here, they have some other ways how walking helps us. So I thought this was pretty amazing. Walking 30 minutes a day helps to reduce our blood pressure by 5 points. It halves our risk of dementia or Alzheimer's. It helps to limit chronic disease. And I like this one, reduces lower back pain, right? So, you know, sitting around too much or you know, sleeping in our beds for too long actually isn't good for our backs. So we do need to get up and move around at some point of the day. Okay. So other things that we want to talk about are healthy eating tips. So if you want to get out there and keep yourself strong enough to walk, you can also add extra calcium into your diet, whether that's through foods that you eat or drink, or also just taking a supplement, right? And we know that it's important when you take calcium, you need other minerals to help your body digest it. So, you know, one thing I learned a long time ago when I worked at General Nutrition Center was make sure you have half as much magnesium as you take calcium if it's a supplement. So that will help your body to absorb the calcium. But a lot of people today are drinking things like bone broth. They're making sure they eat like lots of broccoli. There are vegetables that are good sources of calcium, as well as, you know, eating things like fish. Okay. Make sure you have lean protein to help keep those muscles strong. So you don't lose your muscles. That's important for keeping your frame, keeping the way that we look and our appearance. I actually took a facial yoga class last weekend to help to learn how to exercise your facial muscles so that, you know, we don't have like as much sagging or as much many wrinkles developing. So you can Google that and look into that. Good foods, berries are antioxidants. I have rheumatoid arthritis, so I have a lot of self-immuno-inflammation. My own body attacks my own joints. So some of the things that I found that really helped me to reduce my arthritis and to reduce my pain are turmeric as well as fresh pineapple. Those really help. And I also avoid things that are known to increase inflammation in the body. So like if I'm going to have a tomato, I make sure it's cooked. I don't have like a raw tomato. I don't have like raw green peppers or some of the other nightshade veggies. All right. And make sure you drink lots of water to stay hydrated. It's really good for our bodies. So why do we have to be careful when we're walking? Well, unfortunately, it's because there are a lot more people that are out there that are distracted by their phones. And also, we need to just really be defensive walkers. You know, when we were younger, we were taught to be defensive drivers. And now the lesson is we also have to be careful and watch out for ourselves as we're walking. So there are a lot more drivers. And you can see this right here in the middle, this 49% of drivers under 35 are actually reading or sending text messages as they drive. That is so dangerous. Hopefully you guys are not one of those people. But 65% of drivers are using their cell phones while driving. And some of that is legal. They may have their phones in a phone holder that's attached to the car. So they're not holding it in their hands, which is legal. But you can see the impact in the yellow over here. 23 times, a texting driver is 23 times more likely to get into a crash than a driver who isn't texting. And that's the same as a drunk driver, okay? So people who are texting or using their phones while they're driving are as bad, as dangerous as drunk drivers. So there's a little story here. This is a real story in New Jersey a few years ago. This wonderful, cancer doctor. She was well known in North Jersey. She had adopted 13 foster children, but she was struck by a vehicle at 9:30 in the morning in her neighborhood as she was walking on the sidewalk with her dog. So, you know, people are losing control of their vehicles. So we need to really be careful. There's some speculation that she might have been listening to a podcast and didn't hear, you know, the car coming at her. So it's really important that we don't let ourselves be distracted. So I'm going to share a little clip from one of my favorite shows. I don't know how many of you are Grace and Frankie lovers like I am, but this show has Lily Tomlin and Jane Fonda featured. And I just want to share this clip with you. Hopefully you will be able to see it.
Thanks.
Oh, I'm sorry about this.
No worries. We'll get there.
Retreat!
That seemed quick, didn't it?
Not from the oldest laser tag player in San Diego. Look at this.
Ready?
Get it.
Set. Go! Like you!
Look. Oh, Mother of God. Breathe. Come on, new plan. Jump up on me. You gotta jump.
I'm jumping.
Jump higher. No, try it again. Jump. You know what this is.
Exhausting.
Ageism. This light is too short for anyone over 60.
Oops. Yeah, so, oops, I'm sorry. So that video clip just kind of illustrates, that a lot of times the roads, our infrastructure is not designed for us as we age. You know, we can't move as fast. And you saw that demonstrated in the video, Frankie and her friend were having a hard time getting across the street in the time amount that was listed. So sometimes I always tell seniors, you can be an advocate. You know, if there is like a senior housing development or, you know, a 55 and up development where there's a lot more older folks, then, you know, it's okay to reach out to your township and to ask them if they can adjust the signals on the municipal roads so that there is more time to enable people to get across. That also counts for children. Children need longer. There are other circumstances where you may want to adjust your signal timing so that it's better for you. So these are some of the statistics. In the United States, pedestrian crashes increased 30%, and this is from 2019. So unfortunately, we actually saw that last year, it went up even more. I think it went up another 16% above on top of what this is. And New Jersey is a federal focus state because we have so many people that are getting hit while they're walking and they're biking. So these show the numbers of people that were injured, and unfortunately, it's getting worse. And maybe that some of it is these phones. It could also be other factors. Some of the cars are becoming bigger. People are driving faster. And so those all add together to create more injuries. And I wanted to share this. This is a really well-known fact that if you are hit by a vehicle and it's not going too fast, if it's only going 20 miles an hour, 9 out of 10 people will survive a crash where they're hit at 20 miles an hour. But as you bring the speed up, if the car is going faster, look at 40 miles per hour. Only 1 out of 10 people will survive a crash if they're hit at that speed. So it just goes to show, if you want to make your township safer, see if you can, keep your speed limits down, right? And encourage people to drive slower for safety. And unfortunately, seniors are more likely to be hit and injured because, as we get older, our bone density decreases. So any kind of impact that we have, whether it's falling off of a ladder or just even falling in our homes, but even worse, if we get hit by a car, it's going to be more damaging to our bodies as we're older. And then there's other age-related changes that occur that we're going to talk about. So, our pace, our reaction time slows down as we get older. We may have more joint issues. You could see in that video clip that one lady, she clearly had some kind of things going on with her, maybe with her hips or her knees that didn't allow her to walk as quickly. Sometimes even our ability to turn our heads and to check and see if cars are coming, that can be impacted. So our vision, definitely it happens to all of us as we get older. We can't see as well, and we definitely can't hear as well. So it's important that we're aware of this and of these factors and allow ourselves more time and take that into account when we're, looking at how our roads are designed and which roads we choose to travel when we're walking. So here's another little quick clip.
Let's move out once more onto the crosswalk, dear friends.
So I like this. Here, Frankie has organized all of her friends. They've got this person from the township there. He's climbing. You can see him in the red vest. And he's got a stopwatch. He's timing to see how much time it will take them to cross. And they have asked him to, to make some changes.
Enjoy the morning.
So this is something that you can do in your town.
You see that fence? just normal people trying to get their buffet on without getting sideswiped by a semi.
Yeah, so the whole reason they were trying to cross the street, if you haven't seen that episode, is which is called The Crosswalk, oops, is that they were trying to get to the buffet to get there in time to, you know, when they bring out all the, I think, the crab legs. So other things that can happen as we get older are medication impacts. So you can see what it says there. You know, I have RA, like I told you. I take methotrexate, which is a low dose chemo, every week. And that's to fight my own body from, you know, attacking my joints and making me have worse arthritis. And so I time my medication in relation to my schedule. So if I want to go out, you know, and go walking with some friends, I don't take my medicine, you know, that morning. I wait till I have time and I can just relax at home, because I know that that medication I take is going to make me tired, really fatigued, right? So I may have on the weekends, I may lay in bed, you know, for longer just to relax after I've taken my medication. So these are things, you know, ask your doctors, does the medication you take, does it affect your hearing? Does it make you tired? Because if you're out driving or walking, you know, you need to be alert. And there was a time when my RA doctor prescribed me that hydroxychloroquine, you know, that some people were talking about as a treatment for COVID. That actually impacts your vision. So he started putting me on that. I told him, I don't want to be on that. When I found out that one of the side effects was that I could lose my peripheral vision and my vision would get worse, I said, no way, I don't want to be on that. Let's find a better medication or a better drug to treat me that won't have such terrible side effects. So you can do that. Okay, so we want to go over with you our safe crossing tips. So I'm going to say one, and then you guys can repeat with Mike. All right, we have some hand motions. We use this for the kids, but they also help you remember. So our first rule is stop.
Stop.
Look.
Look.
Listen.
Listen.
And wave.
Wave.
That's right. So stop, look, listen, and wave. So we want to make sure first that you guys will stop at the corner. Don't just step off into the road. You need to make sure, like I said, that it's safe. So we want you to look left, right, left again, over both shoulders. Make sure that there's no cars coming from behind you making the turns or coming from across the street and turning in front of you before you get into the crosswalk. So a lot of people get hit that way. You know, they look and they don't see cars coming, you know, from the right or the left, but they don't realize that there's a car coming from behind them that's making a turn. And if the car doesn't see you in the roadway, they can run right into you. So make sure that you check all around you. We also want to make sure you look at the signals. There's a lot of people in New Jersey, I find, that they cross even on red. And that's really, really dangerous. So we want to just remind you, please obey the signals. They're there for your protection. And there's something that we call a leading pedestrian interval that you can adopt on your signals. So sometimes they have it set so that the cars go and turn and the people are supposed to cross at the same time. That's actually not that safe. A leading pedestrian interval signal is when you set your signals so that the pedestrian gets to go first. They walk out, the cars still have the red, and then the pedestrians get to cross first, and then the cars get the green light so that they can see the people out in the crosswalks before they start turning. That is a lot safer. I don't know if Washington Township has that, but we recommend it. So here's a question for you guys. And Mike, you need to help me to see if they answer. What should you do if the signal turns yellow or you see the red flashing hand?
Don't cross the street.
What if you are crossing already?
At that point, I would keep going.
Good. Very good. Tom, good job. Let's see if other people answer my next quiz question. But good job. Yes. If it's yellow or flashing, it's safer to just wait on the corner, wait till it turns green again, because you may not have enough time to get across the street. Okay, so this is what we want you to look out for. All right. So can someone else tell me how are some of these drivers distracted? How about Mike, call on some of the other people that are watching.
We've all seen people doing this.
And I think there was Anna, right? Anna and Laura.
Jim, Jim, point out some of the things you see with this guy.
Yeah, well, first of all, he's talking on a cell phone. He's distracted because he's drinking a cup of coffee. He's going to kill somebody. And the same thing with the girl. She's drinking a cup of coffee while she's on a cell phone and putting her makeup on.
Yeah, exactly right. So unfortunately, Mike and I have gone out where we do intersection observations, and we see this all the time. And I mean, maybe not all of these at the same time, but we've seen it. And we also see people eating, you know, like drinking their soup, yeah, everything. So people are distracted. So this is why it's so important to make sure you look at them and then get their attention, you know, make sure they see you, wave at them. So that's always, oops, we say wave at the drivers, get their attention. If they wave back, it means they've seen you, okay? And you know it's safe to cross. Okay, so just like you wanna avoid those distracted drivers and not step out in front of them, it's also important for you not to be distracted. So there was a study done by the Wall Street Journal in several major cities. They sent out a roving reporter and an actor dressed up as Chewbacca. And they asked people, have you seen Chewbacca lately? And what they found was that a lot of people didn't see him because they were so busy walking and looking at their phones. So this is a really bad habit. I hope none of you do this, but you can see the guy there in the green hoodie, the lady in the purple shirt, both of them are focused on their phones. They did not see Chewbacca. So the message for you guys is heads up, phones down, listen and be alert. Remember, don't listen to your podcasts or wear headphones when you're walking. You need to be paying attention. Okay, Mike, I think this is you.
Okay, so for here, when you get to the corner and you see the crosswalk button, make sure you press the button. These are pretty interesting stats. 42% of pedestrian fatalities occurred on roads without crosswalks. And 21% occurred when pedestrians didn't use the crosswalk. So the crosswalk's there for a reason, that's your safety zone, so use the crosswalk. Cross at the corner is not at mid-block. It may take a couple more steps to get to the corner, but it's definitely worth it for safety. And then wait for the signal, no matter what time of day, whether it's busy or not, push the button and just wait. It's, you're only gonna wait a few more seconds, so don't be impatient. I got a quiz for a couple questions here. Okay, one, we know to walk on the sidewalk, but if there's no sidewalk, what side of the road should you walk on if there's no sidewalk? So you got right, left, middle. So if there's no sidewalk and you have to walk on the street, what side should you walk on?
Facing the traffic, right?
Yes, which is what side?
Left, right side? No, yeah, right side.
Left side.
Well, what? Yeah, left side. Traffic. Yeah, left side.
You're looking at my fingers. Yeah, left side.
Yeah, so left side. That seems kind of odd, but no, you want to see the cars coming, because if someone is coming this way, you have time to move and you see them in advance because your eyes are going to be up because you're not distracted. Okay. Now, the second one, if you're riding the bike on the road, what side of the road should you be on when you're riding your bike?
Left side.
If you're on the what side of the road should you be riding on if you're riding a bike?
Left side.
What side?
With the flow of traffic.
Well, you're on the right side. You're going with traffic.
All right, then that's the side that you ride on.
Yes. So you want to, when riding a bike on the street or on the road, the cyclist has the same responsibilities as the driver of a car. So you're going to ride on the right side. Now you're going to ride off on the far right, but you're still going to ride in the right side in the same path, following the same signals, laws, etc., as a motorist.
That's interesting.
You say ride right, walk left.
Yeah, so when we speak with the kids, and we always say, look, ride right, walk left. So ride right, walk left. I'm sorry, Jim, I would cut you off there.
No, I used to ride a bicycle, and I remember very clearly the flyer I got, a safety, and it actually had you going the other way, facing the traffic. But now I see we have changed that.
Yeah, when you're riding straight on the same side, that helps you be predictable. And that helps the driver know which way you're going when you're on the bike. So being predictable is really, really important when you're riding on the bike. So.
Okay. And remember, bicycles are vehicles, according to New Jersey law. So they have to follow the same laws as the cars. Yeah. They have to stop at the lights and signals.
I have seen
ride on the right.
Yeah, I've seen people on bicycles blow right through a red light. They just pay no attention.
Very dangerous.
So
they're breaking the law.
So here's one more clip from Grace and Frankie.
So here's Jane. So she's waving. That's what we want you to do, but we want you to do it before you get into the crosswalk, really. Wave before, but you got to see Jane there.
Okay, so now here also too, we're talking about the street and the roads, but you also got to be careful when you're in the parking lots. Parking lots can be very dangerous. And here you'll see on the this was in the news, but two pedestrians in Brick, the Brick ShopRite, ages 90 and 77, they were struck in the parking lot. And even think about it, parking lots are just could be like a mini Indianapolis 500. You got to be so careful. So don't assume that the drivers see you while you're walking. Okay? Remember, we see them, that they don't necessarily see you. So we really got to keep your eyes up and not be distracted. 52% of backup crashes are in parking lots. And again, look both ways and over both shoulders when driving and pulling out. Don't rely on the mirrors or backup camera. Left, right, behind you, both. Look all over the place before you back up, just to make sure. Now here also too, this is a pretty long crosswalk. So when you're gonna go take a walk, whether it's gonna be visiting a friend or shopping, you want to have planned things in advance, plan your path. And here, try and avoid long crosswalks. And these three bullet points kind of make sense, but good reminders. One, on those long crosswalks, there's more exposure to cars because you're out there more. There's a longer distance. It's harder to see the signal from here to over yonder across the street. And it's hard to get across in time, which we saw in Grace and Frankie also too. So at any age, that's a long stretch right there. At any age, that's a good challenge right there to get across the street in time. So avoid long crosswalks.
Yeah. I used to live in Queens, and I have to cross Queens Boulevard. They used to call it the Boulevard of Death. But the New York City has made a lot of good changes now. They put an island, and it's much safer.
And then when we walk, many, many benefits of walking, but walking with friends, it gives you that social aspect. And walking with a friend, not only is it social, but it's actually safer. God forbid if there's an accident or injury, there's somebody there to assist and maybe call. Walking with a friend, it helps drivers see you more because then there's two people as opposed to just one. And then again, we mentioned this earlier on too, walk left facing traffic when there's no sidewalk and you're in the street. And again, I just mentioned this earlier on, plan your walking route in advance, whether you're going to go visiting, shopping, et cetera. If you're going to go for a long stretch, plan for areas that have the crosswalk island in the middle, just so you can stop in the middle if you need to. And then those areas and corners which have the countdown clocks and the pedestrian button too. Now this right here, we go over this a lot with the kids. And
I'm sorry.
Should we just keep going? I'll go back or?
No, I'm going back.
Okay, another way to be safe is to be seen, okay? Again, when we're walking, as pedestrians, we're always looking, eyes up all the time, no distractions, phones away. Well, that doesn't necessarily mean people are going to see you. So you really want to stand out. Nice ways of standing out is wearing bright color clothing. I have a yellow vest on right here. And the picture right there, there's orange color vest, bright color sneaks. Lisa has that she uses this all the time too, which is great, demonstrates the lights on the bottom of the sneaks, so they really stand out. Lights, bike lights for the kids, but also those same lights can be worn by others, by walkers and joggers outside too, just so people can see that light, so they see you coming. So really important for you to be seen, have them notice you. Okay. So use lights, reflectors, and even those lights and reflectors, you can put them on a wall, on your walker or your scooter or your wheelchair too. Okay.
Hey, I have a question, Mike and Lisa. Where can I get those items to possibly order them for our seniors?
You can buy these online. Bike lights.
If you have online for the flashing lights and the vests. Yeah. If you have a particular website, you can send it to me. This way I can make sure all the seniors have, because I do see a lot of seniors walking around, and I think that would be perfect for them.
Yeah, there's some other municipalities where they've done just that. They've bought some reflective vests and they've given them out to the seniors. We were going to offer some later. We have a little quiz. So some of you will have the chance to win either lights or reflective vests if you'd like later. Perfect. But yeah, I'll send you that info, Tom.
Thank you. I want to make sure our seniors are protected in the township.
Sure.
Yeah, because we have expanding our intersections, and the crossing's kind of dangerous, as you've seen in the township.
And this video here, it's watch what the driver does, and it's a very nice video. You'll be able to see what they should be looking for with their eyes up all the time when they're driving, about the pedestrians who's crossing, bike riders, etc. So this highlights it very well.
Yep. So now we're switching over into driving safety tips.
Yeah. So.
We know that you have a lot more younger residents that have moved into town. So, Tom asked us to work with Washington Township to make the roads safer for kids and the young families who are biking and walking around. But we need to be aware of them as we drive. And I forgot to put this in the thing, but March 1st starts the new 4-foot passing law in New Jersey. So just be aware of that you need to stop, slow down, and move over for bicyclists.
Can I get a copy of that law, Lisa?
Yes, we'll send that over.
Thank you. And now, are these, is this a particular new sign that has to be posted?
No, no, this is just a visual.
Because I kind of like it for some of the things around the road here.
Yeah, well, you can see that website there, so you can try and go and they have signs that are like that. You can go and look online and see if you can order some. Sorry, Mike, go ahead.
Okay, so here for sharing the road, okay, so when you're parked and you're going to open, look before you open the car door for other people coming. You could have a cyclist coming or a pedestrian coming. Lisa, what's the right arm rule? I'm not familiar with the right arm rule.
Oh, yeah. So what that means is, let's say you're parking on the right-hand side of the road, and it's a roadway that many people like to bicycle on, but you're parked there. So what it means is you should look over your left shoulder. So imagine I'm in my car, right? And I'm going to open my door. If I open my car door before I get out with my right arm, it actually forces me to look, right? Because if I open it with my left door, my left arm, I could just open the door and hit somebody, right? But if I try to open it with my right arm, it forces me to actually look over my shoulder. I can see if there's any bicyclists or other drivers coming along the road. So my car door doesn't get, you know, torn off or I open my door into a bicyclist.
Second bullet point there, move over a full lane when passing cyclists or stop vehicles or buses, and then stop for the school buses. And then be aware of these other surroundings. Stop for people in the crosswalks. And that previous video was really, really nice how it showed to watch for people in the crosswalks and watching the signs. Stop for people in crosswalk when turning. Look for little ones, little children, because they don't always follow the rules. Plus, sometimes they're so small, you might not be able to see them. And take care around school drop-offs, parks, and urban areas where it could be very congested. And then you have a responsibility of pedestrian safety. So drive safely, not aggressively. You want to obey all laws and signals. Slow down, obviously slow down and obey all limits. So for the street smart, we say heads up, phones down when driving, when walking and driving. So heads up, phones down, put the phones away. Again, no distraction. You got to keep your eyes peeled. There's so much to look for at all times. An accident can happen so quickly. Use headlights at dawn and dusk. Use the high beams when it's dark, but not with oncoming traffic. I think we've all gotten hit with those high beams. So when you see another car coming, put the regular lights on, take off the high beams. But when you can, we use those high beams so you really see much better too. And be aware of blind spots. Check like the little, the picture there, the child. Check for kids in front and back of your vehicle before you drive. Okay, again, they're small, you may not be able to see them. Watch for cyclists riding on your right. Even watch for other cars riding and driving on your right. A lot of people want to pass on the right. You got to be careful and keep your eyes peeled for that as well. And avoid being in a blind spot of other cars or when walking and biking. So be aware when you're driving, especially those big tractor trailers, in their blind spot right there when you're on the right-hand side. So give them space, give them room, because they're so large. You see, again, you see them, they don't necessarily see you. And then idling. Idling is when the car is on and you're not moving. And there's a lot of issues with idling, especially now for environmental issues, especially for children. Asthma is the number one chronic disease of kids, and idling makes it worse. So if they inhale those fumes, it could bring on an asthmatic attack or enhance an asthmatic attack. Okay. For kids, and this is why it's important for maybe have anti-idling campaigns at schools. Kids breathe in 50% more air pollution per pound of body weight than adults and are more affected because their lungs are still growing. Okay, and what do we do when we go pick up kids or children at school? We leave the car running. But an idling car or a truck produces 20 times more pollution than a car going 30 miles an hour. So a good idea to have, or good suggestion or recommendation or thought to have an anti-idling campaign at schools.
We've actually completed that last year in all our schools. They got signs posted on the schools to stop the idling.
Oh, that's great. That's great.
Great job. Great job.
Yeah, that's great. Yeah. Okay, another quick pop quiz. Okay, we went over all this. Let's see if you remember. Okay, what should you...
Mike, can you keep track of who answers? Because then we'll let them get a prize.
Oh, all right. How about what should you wear to be safe? What's an example of some stuff you can wear, you should wear to be safe?
Oh, I like this one. Reflective vests, flashing lights. I want a pair of Lisa's sneakers.
I got them at Walmart.
Really?
They were literally like $10 a pair.
No way.
Cool. Okay. Number two, here's one. What do you do to ensure drivers see you?
Okay, someone else. So Tom got the first question. Okay.
You should wave to the driver before you cross the street.
Yeah, very nice. Yeah.
Who was that that answered? Who was that that
Barbara.
Answered?
Barbara.
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 What's your last name?
Finnegan.
Finnegan, okay.
Yeah, so that wave is very important. You want to make ensure that you see eye contact with them. Plus, it's also a way of saying, hey, it's being polite. Hey, thanks for stopping. Thanks for not hitting me. But you're making contact as well.
Right, I was going to say you should also walk facing the traffic.
That's, yes, very good too, yeah.
Since I walk with a bunch of women every morning, these are rules that we have to follow.
You know, and you need to be careful too, because sometimes we ladies get so involved in chatting with one another, we're not really paying attention to traffic. So just be aware and keep, you know, protect each other.
Yes, we break down into small groups, so we're behind each other.
Oh, good. Okay. Yeah. But that's right, Lisa, as she mentioned, that the conversation, while it's great, it could also be a distraction also, too. So be careful. Still converse, but do it safely. Okay, the third one. Those dome pads that you see on the street at the corners, they got all the bumps in it and everything. What are the dome pads on the streets for?
Handicapped.
What type of handicap? Yeah. We didn't actually tell you guys this, we forgot, but.
Wheelchair? Yeah. Wheelchair, probably.
No.
Except I never see anybody ever using them.
That's a good guess though, but it's not, it's not the wheelchairs.
Bikes, carriages, so the things don't slip, so people don't trip, senior citizens that don't trip.
Think of it as a form of Braille.
Is it really?
You're right. You're absolutely right. It tells you the entrance and the exit where you're crossing. It's sort of like a non-slipping thing.
No, not so much non-slipping, but it's for people who are visually impaired or blind. Okay,
well, I wanted to include that with the visual impaired. You know, they know not to take right off the curb, but yeah, that's right.
I think you see more handicapped people using them than visually impaired.
Well, they're designed for the blind, like the seeing eye dogs are trained. Mm-hmm. To stop their owners, but it's for them, like if they're feeling with, they have like a cane, or if they feel it with their foot, they know, oh, I'm about to go into the roadway. And they also actually guide them. So depending on how they're positioned, that's how a person who's totally blind knows which way they should walk, you know, to cross the street. And then when they reach the other side, they can feel the other one. And it's also for those who are maybe just starting to lose their vision. They're bright colored, right? They're yellow, they're red, they're blue.
Right. Eyes are red.
Yeah.
All right. Here's question number four. What are unsafe walking habits? So what are the big no-nos in walking? If you're walking outside as a pedestrian, what are some of the no-nos?
Walking with your phone, walking with your, talking with large groups, walking with the traffic, not following the signs. There's so many of them.
Cool.
Who is that? Is that somebody else?
No, it's me, Barbara.
Barbara. Try and get some of the other people too so they can get a prize.
Are there any other people?
Where's Jim? Where's Patty?
I'm here.
Wasn't there someone named Anna and Laura?
I'm still trying to figure out why I can't get my camera to work, but I'm here.
But we can hear you, so you can answer the question.
Okay.
The big prize is a Maserati at the end.
No, that's from Tom.
You just gotta put it. You just gotta put it together with glue.
Okay. And here's the last one. Okay, what types of streets should you avoid?
Wide ones, busy ones, ones that don't have little medians in the middle, so you can't rest and stay up before you get hit by a car.
Yeah, extra wide, very wide ones. You can't
go on crosswalks. Yeah.
Very heavy traffic ones like Pascack Road, Washington Avenue. Those are dangerous.
Mm. Cool. Good job.
Good job. Good job. Good Hopefully job. You know what, Tom? I'm just going to give you some prizes and you're going to be the person who's responsible for getting them to the people who answered because I can't see it all.
That's okay. No problem. I got their names written down.
Okay, good, good.
Yeah. Yeah, this slide here is a little bit of a plug for Easy Ride. Now, Easy Ride, myself and Lisa were on the bike and pedestrian team. It is responsible for other forms of transportation also. There's carpools, vans, et cetera. Here they have a program called Ride for Life. And it's a little plug for Ride for Life. So it's on the transportation in partnership with TNC, Lyft, and Uber. Low cost. There's discounts available for seniors. And it's not limited to just older or 18 plus. And for any information, that phone number there, that's Lisa's, well, that's our Easy Ride number, 201-939-242. And extension 4 will take you to the contact person. So if you know somebody or you yourself needs transportation to a pharmacist, doctor, that could, that'd be able to, a good form of assistance for you.
Hey, Mike, can I post this on our VFW website?
Yeah, of course. I can send you a brochure too. You mean just this slide or everything?
I need everything, but this slide, because we have some handicapped veterans that would like to, you know, sometimes they can't get a ride and they're reaching out to another veteran in town to see if they can take them down to the VA hospital. But this here would be perfect for them.
Yeah, this is helpful too. So for people who can no longer drive safely, right? Then they can have that independence. They don't have to feel like they have to depend on a friend or a family member. So yeah, we'll definitely share this with you.
Yeah, thank you. That's good information here.
And then thank you for taking the time and listening to me and Lisa. Does anybody else have any additional questions?
No, but if you look, behind me, we're still being televised on the TV. I left the TV on so you can see we're televised. And I have a couple of seniors that called me that said they're watching the TV.
So, oh, great.
Very nice. Cool.
So we're going to do this again tonight at 8, what Rick said. And Jim, could you please make sure you get that out to your seniors that they can watch this?
All right, I got that.
And I'll give you some extra prizes so that people who watch tonight.
No problem. 8 o'clock.
You won't be able to quiz them in person, but you can just give out some random prizes to some of the people who watch tonight.
Sure.
Thank you.
Absolutely.
Anyone have any questions?
No, but I learned something today.
Thank you very much.
Okay. Thank you very much for the presentation. It's very good.
Bye-bye.
Okay. All right. Bye.
Bye, everyone.
All right,
bye.
Please,
bye-bye, guys.
Thank you. Be safe, be seen.